Just a quick YouTube I'm making about fig cuttings, growing fig bushes from cuttings. So, actually, I learned this trick from other YouTube videos. So I basically I saw that you could start with a friend's fig tree, although you can actually buy different fig cuttings on the internet. And the key is to have new growth. So you look for part of the branches that grew in the current season or the most recent season, because that's because figs only grow on branches apparently that are new growth. So these points, these nodes, you want just about two or three nodes in a branch. You cut it at an angle. Actually, these are stored in the fridge, so I cut all of these at the same time, and I wasn't sure it would work, so I put some in the fridge, and I'm going to do that in February. I'm going to grow some more. So basically, this is how I did it. So I took old water bottles. I cut off the top, and in most cases, I actually made holes in the bottom. You really probably should. Some of them did work without the holes in the bottom, but you need drainage, because the key with cuttings is you don't want, like this one actually didn't grow, so maybe that was a problem because I didn't see everything, but it did grow roots, but it didn't sprout. So what you'll notice, the nice thing about clear plastic bottles, individual, so actually what I did at first was, so you never believe anything you learn on YouTube. So what I saw at first was a man who had all his cuttings in the same bucket, and he covered it with a bag for 3 weeks, put it under his porch, and it grows roots. And you can tell when you tug on it, it doesn't, after 3 weeks, that there's roots because it doesn't come right out of the soil. But the problem with that method was that all the roots were connected together. In fact, this one had a huge root base. That was in August, July, August, September, September, October, November. So in 4 months, this one still, because I had to rip all the other sticks around it, it ruined it. It's damaged its root base, and I could tell it's not dead yet, so, because it's still green at the ends. So I have a feeling that once it recovers, it's a long recovery, it will grow again. But putting them all together, even though that YouTube had a lot of views, probably wasn't a good idea, because all the roots get really hurt when you have to put them out and separate them. So I found better was to put it in individual bottles. Let's see if we can get some light on the roots here. So the first thing that comes out, you'll see, is the root structure. And the key also is the type of soil. Now, one of the popular fig YouTubers said not to use this very lightweight stuff called Coco CUIR. I don't know how to pronounce it, but it's very, very lightweight. It's got perlite in it. And it's usually for plant, you know, growing flowers in, but the problem, as she said, is when she transplanted them. So they grow great, and maybe you get 80% of your sticks are gonna sprout leaves in the Coco CUIR. But her problem was transplanting them, and they would die because the root ball falls apart very easily because the soil isn't very sticky. So unlike tomato plants, which you do not transplant when they're wet to larger pots, I found that if you wet this and then you clip down the plastic and you very, very carefully make sure that you keep the root ball all together, you clip it down and it's wet and you hold it together and then you put it in a new pot like I did with these, with real soil added around the root ball, that they did transplant fine. So, you know, when I do this again, I will again use Coco CUIR. I'll just be very careful when I take the root ball out. So you can see, I mean, it just grew a really great leaf on top. And And it looks like it might grow a new one right there at the base. So that's where they grow branches, always at those bends. So here's, oh my gosh, I just noticed that that this one is actually starting to grow a fig on it. Look at that. Oh my God. So another key, basically with plants, it's about soil, water drainage, light, and aeration. So here you have these grow lights. Here I sophisticatedly taped them with duct tape to my countertop. So, you know, pretty low tech, and every now and then that light falls down, I have to retape it. There's another kind of lights. Sticks are not very strong. There's not a lot of watts, but these little cheap things that you can also clip on your countertop. Now, these grew actually okay over 3 months without the special light. I was just using the regular LEDs that are built under my countertop, but that wasn't that fast, and it did definitely, growth picked up when I started to use the grow lights, which are enriched for blue light. So with plants that are in their vegetative phase, they're not flowering or fruiting, they do better with when the light's enriched with blue. So your average light that you have in your kitchen is probably just a balance of red and blue. The other thing that's really key is a ventilator fan with a heater. Now this one has a timer on it, so when I turn it on, I set the timer immediately so it doesn't go more than 3 hours, because you don't want a house fire. Not to mention it burns a lot of fuel. So figs grow best at around 72 degrees. No one really can afford to keep their house that warm in winter. So every morning I'll turn it on for 3 hours, and every night before I go to bed, maybe once in the day. So that extra warmth and the ventilation is very key, because I noticed that over the soil early on without ventilation, that you can get mold and fungus growing. And then sometimes the leaves pick up that fungus. So actually cut off leaves that were getting fungus and some of the plants, because it made me nervous, but they had other leaves that could grow. But this is pretty exciting. I can't believe it's growing a fig. Let's see, now my other prize plant. So here's a branch that I cut off the tree that had some branches to it. So it's pretty thick. So I went up the branch, and I wasn't sure it was gonna grow, because YouTube told me that you want new growth, but this, you know, might have been last year's growth. By the way, before you put it in the Coco CUIR, you have to dip the end of that cutting in rooting hormone. You dip that in, and then you stick it in the Coco CUIR, and then you cover it with plastic for 3 weeks, and then you keep it at 72 degrees. So that creates like a very moist environment. When you have the moist soil with a little cover over it, it's sitting, could be outside, but in winter it's gonna have to be inside as close to 72 degrees as possible. And then when you're growing it, you're gonna watch for its roots. You're not gonna, this tipped over, scared me. Yeah, it's a bit tall. You know, you don't have to cut them this tall. So I would just say in the future, if you're going to your friend's tree and you want to cut it, just look for 1, 2, 3 nodes. Like this one, it only had 1, 2 nodes, 3 nodes. You can see one's coming out of the bottom. So, you know, 3 nodes is probably enough. When you get really long like that, 1, 2, 3, so it's actually not a lot, it's just spaced out. All right, it's just, I probably could have planted it like here, cut it here, and not have to deal with that top heavy. I have to transplant that soon. With leaves that big, this really, I need to do it this weekend. So I wasn't sure that this would, turn this fan off for now. I wasn't sure that this older growth would take, but in fact, to me, it looks a little bit better because it had multiple branches in it. It can almost, you know, it could almost have a balanced formation. Whereas these sticks, you know, you often just come out on one side and you get a funny tree that you know, it just has one sprout. You want it to kind of, if you can, come out in multiple places so that it might actually balance itself out. So anyway, oh wow. So all that green is, you know, growth since it's been in the pot. That's new growth, and the stick was how I got it. And you can see little guy's gonna come out on the end here. Anyway, I kind of call this beginner's luck. I love to eat figs, and I always fantasize about, you know, because you see neighbors with their fig trees, and I mean, I think maybe this will survive to the ground, but in any case, just in case, I'm going to start a few. I'll make a video when I just start this from the ground up from the beginning, so you can see how it goes, and I'll time lapse it. But I just thought that this was pretty cool, and in case they all die, I better make a video of that little baby fig there. Can't believe it. It's December, and I started this about August, and then there's a little fig. That's so cute. All right, so hopefully they'll survive. Thank you for watching.